opened back in 2010. We're on the air from Target Field here in downtown Minneapolis. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the Atlanta Braves and the St. Louis Cardinals. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. In is Jorge Soler. He will lead this one off today. The 3-1. And that misses for ball four. So it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon. Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. Two balls and a strike to Freeman.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
And that's out number one. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzie Albies.
The second baseman.
One out and a runner on second base. All even now, 2-2. From the belt, the pitch.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
The 2-2 one more time. He turns on it and sends it deep down the line and right. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Stepping in for the Braves, Austin Riley, runner in scoring position with two gone. Soler on third with two out. Breaking pitch and this bounces in front of the catcher.
One out away from stranding that runner on third. So the last thing you want to do is throw a wild pitch and let him score. Nice job there by the catcher to knock that one down.
And he fouls this one off. Popped up. Goldschmidt is under it. And he makes the catch to retire the side. That brings in Tommy Edman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 1-1. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And he is going to have extra bases here to start the home first. And he will make it there as the Cardinals get a man into scoring position on the leadoff double.
The first baseman, Paul.
So now to the plate, Paul Goldschmidt. Hit out towards second. Albies brings it in. And there's one down now. Stepping in for the Cardinals, Tyler O'Neill. First trip to the plate for him in this one, and it's a good RBI spot, too. Leadoff man at third with one down. Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2.
Trying to do way too much up there for what I can tell. He knows that's a big run standing there at third, but that swing was way out of control. You still have to stay within yourself and look for your pitch.
Still 2-2. One out and a runner on third. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Squared that one up just a little late.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
Now a swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Riley is under it. Two gone. The next to bat for St. Louis, Nolan Arenado. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's got a 3-for-7 line. He also has one home run. 2-2. Here it is. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. digging in will be Adam Duvall. He'll be in there to start things out against Adam Wainwright. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. A shot down the first baseline. And he's going to kick off the second with extra bases. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
That is good. The left fielder, number eight, Eddie Rosario.
Into the box, Eddie Rosario. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Little chopper back to the mound. And there's one away. So now here is Travis d'Arnaud looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Now the 3-2 pitch. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. Reined in. Throw on to first, two gone. So a man at third here with two gone. And that brings up the former number one overall pick, Dansby Swanson. The set and the 2-1.
Count is 3-1.
Duvall at third with two away. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. So in now is the Atlanta pitcher, Max Fried, and their runners at the corners now. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
A swing and a foul tip, but held onto behind the plate, and they're going to get out of danger here as the strikeout will end the inning. Last half of the second set to go. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina. Now the 3-2 pitch. Gets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four. Next up, Dylan Carlson. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Now the 2-1 pitch. Runners on the move for second. Shot down the line. It's a fair ball. Molina rounds third and is digging for the plate, and a relay home, a tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. At the plate now, Edmundo Sosa, high and deep down the left field line, and it's a foul ball. Now the 3-2 pitch, sent in the air out to straightaway central. Duvall is there, two gone. Next to hit, Harrison Bader. Lifetime versus this arm. He's one for two.
Harrison Bader.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The set and the 1-2. Chases out of the zone for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. Top of the third set to get underway, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Jorge Soler. And that misses 2-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. So here is Freddie Freeman. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Tapped out in front of home. Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. Two down, no one on base. And that'll bring up the exciting Ozzie Albies. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. A swing and a miss there. Two and two.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
The 2-2 one more time. Hit on the ground to short. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. So here now's the pitcher, Adam Wainwright, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Albies ranging into the outfield. He can't get to it. This one's down.
Now back, second baseman, Tommy.
Into the box now, Tommy Edman. He takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
Fastball swung on and missed.
Two strikes.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Wainwright on at first. Nobody out. Curveball bounces, and this one gets away. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Here's the payoff pitch. Oh, he's caught looking at a beautiful curveball there as that buckled him for the first out of the inning.
The first baseman.
Next up is Paul Goldschmidt. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. He's falling behind now, 3 and 1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher's going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Now batting.
Next to dig in, Tyler O'Neill. He popped out in his first trip. Two and one, here it is. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Two and two.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Soler is there. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Set for the start of the fourth, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Austin Riley.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
Payoff pitch one more time. Toward the gap in right center. This is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Swing and a miss, and the count goes full, 3-2.
Got him to chase after the curveball below the zone there. That was a really nice pitch, and it can be a really tough one to lay off of as a hitter.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. The next 3-2. misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Left fielder, number eight.
Digging in next, Eddie Rosario. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Now the 2-1 pitch. No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Carlson is in a few steps as he takes it for the first down. The tag, and they got him at third. It's a double play. The next to bat for Atlanta, Travis d'Arnaud. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
And the count will be full.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Hits this one hard the other way. A dive, and he knocks it down. But they'll still manage to get the out on the force. And with that fine play, the inning comes to an end. Here's Nolan Arenado. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Swanson is there. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. Yadi Molina digging in now. Drew a base on balls his first time up. No runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And this pitch misses for a ball. 2-1 now to Molina. Two and two to the Cardinals catcher.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
There to pull it in is Soler, and there are two away. So now into the box is Dylan Carlson. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
And look out. That one ran in and got him. Now at the plate is Edmundo Sosa. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. The 1-1 home.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Dansby Swanson. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Center fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down. Up next, Max Fried struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs. Sometimes it just comes down to pure execution.
Nope.
Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Another 2-2 offering. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. One out, nobody on. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Jorge Soler. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
That pitch was way down on 2-2, but give the hitter some credit there. Sometimes with two strikes, you're more apt to expand the strike zone, but he didn't and held off on that one that wasn't even close.
And this one misses inside a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and into bat next, one of the fastest players in all of baseball, Harrison Bader. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. The 3-2 pitch. Drilled down the line, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Now batting.
No so pitcher. In now is the Cardinals pitcher, Adam Wainwright, who collected a base hit his first time up.
Yeah, he showed like a little prowess with the bat right there, Dan. I'd be surprised if they don't attack him a little bit more carefully this AB.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Adam Wainwright becomes out number two this inning. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. And it misses, 3-1 now.
Three balls, one strike.
Paul Goldschmidt would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And this one misses inside a ball he walked in, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Now back.
Now at the plate here is Paul Goldschmidt. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
The batter, the left fielder, Tyler.
To the plate now, Tyler O'Neill. And it's fouled away. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And that misses 2-2. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So up steps Ozzy Albies. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Foul tip that's held on to with the plate, and the count moves to 1-2 now.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
The next 3-2. Lifted the other way out to left center. Chasing after it is O'Neill, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out. So now to the plate, Austin Riley.
It's
1-2. This is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Stepping up is Adam Duvall. Base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Can't do much with that one. It's 1-2. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. He makes the throw to first, two down. Striding in is Eddie Rosario, trying here to plate the tying run from second. The set and the 1-1. Hit down the line at first. Fielded by Goldschmidt, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Chris Martin enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 55.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Got him to go after the change there, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
Good battle, count remains full. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
The catcher, number four.
Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. Two balls and a strike to Molina.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. Stepping in now, Dylan Carlson. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. So next to hit is Edmundo Sosa. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Hit to short. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. And now here is Harrison Bader. Lifetime against this particular arm. Not a big sample size, 0 for 1. The 1-1 home. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Cody Whitley will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Paul DeJong will also come on now, as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Hit hard on the ground to third. Gloved by Arenado. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Now into the box. Dansby Swanson flew out last time up. Ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Three balls and a strike to the Atlanta shortstop.
I got 3-1. Three balls, one strike.
Fastball too high. Ball four. Guillermo Heredia come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 38. Guillermo Heredia.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And the recovery throw is too late, and there are two on with one away now. Standing in now, Jorge Soler. And he fouls this one off. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And another foul ball.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
And he got him.
The first baseman, number five.
Freddie Freeman will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two.
A time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
High and deep to right center. Going back is the right fielder. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Into the box now, Ozzie Albies. Hit on the ground out to short. DeJong fields it cleanly. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Richard Rodriguez gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. And now, Paul DeJong. He's newly entered into the ball game, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. One gone for the Redbirds in the seventh, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman. Swung on but fouled off to the left. 1-2 is taken for ball two. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. Throw will not be in time at first. A good effort that time, but not enough to prevent them from getting a one out base runner. In now, Paul Goldschmidt. There's strike two as the slider hits the outside corner.
Two strikes.
Very weakly on the ground, but that one rolls foul.
Hey, doubled up on breaking balls there outside. Now might be the time to bust that fastball in.
Try again, 1-2. Got him swinging. The throw. Not in time as the offline throw allows him to get in there easily. So a runner at second, two down now, and into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. So here's the cleanup hitter, Austin Riley. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. 1-1 count. Here's the pitch.
That's the ball.
And now a good slider that doesn't quite catch the zone. It's 2-1 now. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here now the 2-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Fouled away. The next 3-2. Hit on the ground toward the left. DeJong gathers it in. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. So next to bat will be Adam Duvall, one for two with a double on the ledger so far. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. This will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. The bouncer to the left side. Scooped up. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Next to stand in is Eddie Rosario. He grounded out last time up. Left side. DeYoung's got it. Off-balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single. Into the box, Travis d'Arnone. This is in the air to right. Carlson gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. The 1-1. In the air out to center field. Duvall is right there, one down. Ready now is Yadier Molina, a hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame.
A little bit of a unique home run of that last one, a changeup in off the plate that he pulled for a home run. Not a real good idea to throw that changeup on the inner half of the plate. More executed, well executed changeups are more down and away.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Dylan Crossan. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. From the windup, the 1-1. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite hit the bottom of the zone. Just hung in there on that one. Both teams with 6 hits so far. Out in front as he rolls over it to second. Albies scoops it up, and 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Genesis Cabrera is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number 6 spot following the double switch. Lars Nootbaar will also enter as a part of the double switch as he'll hit in the 7 hole in the lineup. Now the 2-1. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. Racing back the right fielder. It's out of here, and they've taken the lead in the 9th. Santa Maria. Jock Peterson will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
For Atlanta, number 22.
Base is empty here with nobody out. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number 1. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Jorge Soler. One run in and one gone so far in this inning. The 1-1.
Nope, outside. Down to 3-1.
Freddie Freeman there. He'll hit next. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. And he takes ball 4 again. And they clearly just don't want any part of him in this one. Now at the plate, Freddie Freeman. He's got one hit in four at-bats.
Yeah, now that last one wasn't exactly a tape measure shot. But listen, a home run is a home run. I know a lot of pitchers, but they call that a...
Now, meanwhile, the throw to second is there, and he is out trying to steal the base. Here comes the 1-2.
Man, if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to throw that same pitch until he proves he can lay off of it.
This one misses, and that will fill the count here. 3-2 with two away. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Will Smith comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Number 51.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder, Lars Nootbaar. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
Now batter, center fielder.
So now to the play, Harrison Bader. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Outside with the fastball as the count moves to 2-1 now. Swing, and he rockets this one down the left field line. And that's going to get your tying run in scoring position, as it ought to be good for extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double. Number 64 will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 64.
Bader, the runner at second with one away.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Sent on the ground out to second. Albies picks it up on the first, and that means the Cardinals are down to their final out now. So stepping in is Tommy Edmond, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Popped him up. Darno over to his left. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
A one-run finish, 4-3, the final tally today. Atlanta came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Richard Rodriguez pitches well enough to get the W. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon for the victorious Atlanta Braves. 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For St. Louis, 3 runs on 7 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 3 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.